I'm Marvin Justus, and I race Tether cars.
On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my
Tether car here. It runs in the 3A class. There are several different classes. 3A is one that has a very specific chassis, has a very specific motor in it. Yeah.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, now touch me, babe. Can't you see that I am not afraid?
This car in the 3 class, the record is 173. This car just won the Nationals at 162 here 2 weeks ago in Southern California.
Ready, Stu?
Ready.
We race these every other weekend. There's actually 3 tracks in America, one here in Southern California, one in Indiana, and one in New York. The sport really began way back in the late 1930s. And was really popular in the 50s and the 60s. It kind of went to the sidelines with the advent of the RC cars, which actually derived itself from the Tether cars. So there is a very select group. It's called the AMRCA, American Miniature Race Car Association. A typical weekend is we'll go to the track and we'll use the morning to do testing, to kind of get our car dialed in for the day because of the weather conditions. These little motors are very sensitive to temperature, humidity, air density, and so those corrections have to be made each and every day and throughout the day. So of the morning we do make 3 runs, then of an afternoon we do our actual heats runs, and they are all computer generated times, and it's the average of 8 laps is your overall time. So even though you may have one lap 165, it averages out over 8 laps. And you must decide what 8 laps you want to take by the push of a button. And that is non-reversible, unfortunately. But we constantly have to listen to the cars, listen to the engine, how fast it comes up. These cars are, when we push them off, they are carburetor is running at wide open, and so initially for the first 12, 15, 20 laps they will be running what we call rich. They will be really full of fuel. They'll be exhausting a lot of fuel for those first few laps, and as the engine gets warmed up and pick up speed, the engine will slowly clean itself out and come up to speed. We constantly have to listen to the engine, watch the car. When I say watch the car, you can usually watch your car through up about 125, 130 mile an hour. After that, you pretty much lose the car. It's you can see a little puff of smoke, and that's about it.
And all the science, I don't understand.
So the sound, the audible sound is very, very important to tell us exactly what the car is doing. We make changes throughout the day. Tire diameters, that's our only gear ratio. The gear ratio is a constant, and so we have to change the diameter of the rear tires to determine our overall gear ratio. On any given day, we can go up or down depending upon whether or not we want more RPMs or more speed. One of the things about Tether cars is that regardless of what you've raced automobiles in the past, whether it be anywhere from go-karts all the way up to Atlantics, much of the same things that they worry about is what we worry about. We worry about fuel management, carburation, tires, the way the chassis is actually handling. So all those factors come into play, and it's 8 laps at 162 mile per hour. It takes about 6.9 seconds. So you don't have a lot of time to make a lot of decisions on the performance of the car.
Rocket Man, burning out the fuse of hair alone. And I think it's gonna be a long, long time it's gonna be a long, long time. And I think it's gonna be a long, long time. And I think it's gonna be a long, long time. And I think it's gonna be a long, long time.